With the pandemic continuing to rage on, Pfizer inked a new deal this morning with the U.S. government for more COVID-19 vaccine doses. Let's get right to Yahoo Finance healthcare reporter Anjali Kamlani with more. Anjali?
Thanks, Brian. Yeah, so we just got word this morning that that negotiation that was really a key focus in the recent weeks for the U.S. government to purchase additional doses of Pfizer and BioNTech's vaccine after it received emergency use authorization has been finalized for an additional 100 million doses. So if we recall, Pfizer and BioNTech already got that purchase order for 100 million doses earlier this year for about $1.95 billion. And right now, the total amount of Pfizer's vaccine that the U.S. government is agreeing to purchase is 200 million for a total of about 4 billion. So that's the purchase order right now. The agreement between them does include an additional 300 for a total of 500 million, according to what the agreement was back in July. So right now, fulfilling that. Now, of course, we remember part of the reason why this is a big deal is because there were reports of a Pfizer board member had said that the U.S. government had turned down advanced orders ahead of time before we even knew that the vaccine was going to reach the finish line, that it was going to be first out the door, that it was going to get that EUA this year. So all of that to say that now the U.S. government is able to make good on that, and Pfizer is able to provide those. Of that additional 100 million doses, 70 million are due by the end of June 2021, and the remainder by July 2021 in order to meet the U.S. government's goal of vaccinating everyone by June of next year. A quick side note on that, though, however, we do know that health experts say that's a very optimistic timeline, sorry, and that we might actually end up getting into Q3 before everyone is vaccinated. Brian?
And Anjali, I actually want to follow up on this for just a moment, because when you talk about those new Pfizer doses included in this order, it sounds like they're not going to be delivered for a while. What about the reports that we have heard from various states that they are not getting as much vaccine as they had anticipated? This then doesn't seem to go towards addressing that issue.
I'm glad you brought that up. So let's cover a few of the reasons for this. First of all, just basic descriptor on what it takes to produce vaccines. It's actually not an exact science, the same way that you could maybe put ingredients and produce a pill. Vaccine production, especially this, is not exact. The batches come out just a little bit different. The result is a little bit different each time in terms of quantity. And so they're not able to put an exact number in many cases on what each batch looks like. So that has played a role in sort of why Pfizer was unable initially to sort of provide that. And that led to the government not buying these doses right offhand because they didn't have a deadline for it. Now, why the discrepancy between what the states reported they were getting, that is based on what seems internally to be some sort of misunderstanding on the exact process and the timeline of what the FDA does in terms of being able to get those vaccines filled and finished, then allow them to be released and have that approval for release. That's what General Perna said, and he is with Operation Warp Speed over the weekend to kind of explain it. He took responsibility for it, saying that this is on him. So that's something that we're still sort of learning what the reasons behind all this is. But as it stands right now, it looks like they've kind of figured out what the wrinkles were, and we shouldn't be hearing more about this based on what we know now.
Anjali Kamlani, thanks so much.